Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Today's video is the topic of discussion. Lancashire boiler definition, parts, working, application, advantages and disadvantages. Lancashire boiler is a horizontal drum exit. Natural circulation, natural draft, two tubular, low pressure stationary fire tube boiler with furnace located internally. It is main purpose it to create steam, and then this steam is used to drive steam turbines for power generation. It has high thermal efficiency and it is about 80 to 90%. It is mostly used in locomotive engine and marine etc. Main part of Lancashire boiler: safety valve, water level indicator, pressure gauge, steam stop valve, feed sink valve, blow up valve, main hole, fusible plug, grate, fire tube, ash pit. Accessories that are used in the Lancashire boiler: economizer, air preheater, superheater, feed pump. Now to the animated video, we will be shown the working of the Lancashire boiler.
First, I show you how to draw the figure of Lancashire boiler. So here you see that it is a 3D figure of Lancashire boiler. Okay, so it is a one cylindrical component. Okay, so on a side view it's looking the circle, and when we see from front view, means we are observing this Lancashire boiler from this side, then we see it is a one rectangle. When we see from the top, it is also looking the rectangle. Okay, so this cylindrical cell is looking on different part from the different view. Okay, so first we draw the cylindrical cell. So this is the front view. Okay, so when we see from this side, it's look the only rectangle. When we see from the side, it is looking the circular portion. So we draw the circle in a side view. And when we see from the top, at that time they are also looking as the rectangle. Okay. And this part is known as the boiler cell. Now inside the boiler cell, the main is the fire tubes. So here we see that it is the fire tube. That is a two fire tube is available. Okay. But when we see from the front view, then we are able to only watch the one fire tube, means one is back on the another side. So when we arrange the two pan back to others, okay, and we visualize, then it's look only the one pan. Okay, so in a front view it is a one fire tubes. When we see from the side view, it's have a two fire tubes. So here we draw the two circle. Okay, and when we see from the top, means this from the top view, so it's look the two tubes individual. So in this top view we are draw the two fire tubes. Okay, so inside the fire tubes the flue gases is moving, that's why it is known as the fire tube, means hot gases are moving, that's why it is known as the fire tube. Okay, and it is also known as the flue tubes. Now this cylindrical cell is covered by the brick construction, so we are need to arrange the different brick construction outside the cell. This in this image you are not able to see the cell. But you are not able to see the brick construction. So we draw the brick construction. So it is the brick construction. The cell of this boiler is installed above this brick construction. Okay. So here it is provide the support. This part is the chimney. So similarly, the brick construction is provided on the older view. So we are providing in the side view. Means side view here the some brick construction is provided on this side. Another is on the this side, so it is noted. Okay, and when we drawing the brick construction on the sides, and when we visualize from the top, so we are drawing here the one brick construction this side, means on this side there is a brick construction, so it is drawn on this side as well as on the bottom side. Okay, so this brick construction is showing from this side brick construction, and this upper side is knowing as this side brick construction. Okay, and this is the back side, means this part construction is there. Now Here also the big construction is provide for the divergence of the flue gases that is coming out from this tube that we seen in details during the working. Here the fire grate is provided, means it is a furnace. Here the burning of the coil is takes place. Okay. And this blue part is the fire bridge. Okay. And this is the fire door. From this fire door, we supplying the different fuel that is a generally coal is supplied from this fire door. And this is MF is the main flow. Main flow means flow of the hot gases that is produced in a furnace or a grate. That is main pass from these fire tubes. Okay. Then after this, this is the end point of the main flow. Then after it is go to the bottom flow. Okay. Bottom flow means it is exhaust on this side. Then it is start to move in this bottom of the boiler cell. Means between the boiler cell and between the brick. So here the flow of the bottom flow here. Okay. But here first I noted the main flow in a different view. Okay. Then after the bottom flow, means it is the bottom side of the flow. Okay. So it is the bottom side. And in a side view, it is the bottom side. In a top view, we are not showing it is the bottom side. Because when we seeing from a top view, this is known as the side face. And here it is also known as the side face. So bottom view is looking only from the side and only from the front. Okay. That's why here we are not mentioning it is the bottom flow. But it is the side flow. In a top view, this is the one side and this is the another side. So here we written as a side flow or a side flue SF. So during this working, we can understand in details about the how the side flow is that. So side flow is also on the side view. Okay. In a front view, side flow is not able to visualize. And outside of these flue tubes or a fire tubes, the water is there. So here we draw the waters in a different view. So first I draw in this front view. So it is the water level. Then after, in a top view, this is a two tubes and surrounding of them, water is there. And in a side view, also the water is there. Okay. So these are the main construction. Now there is a different mounting is also installed on a boiler. So now we start the different mountings. So first one is the damper. This damper is used to control the mass flow rate of the flue gases. That we understand later on why it is installed. Here this is portion where the steam is collected. Here the safety valve. Then after this manhole for a inspection purpose or a cleaning of this boiler. And this is a steam stop valve and this yellow part is known as the removing the moisture from a steam. Then after next it is again the one safety valve. That is generally two safety valve is installed in a boiler. This is the pressure gauge which indicate the pressure of the steam. And here the water level indicator, it is used to check the level of the water inside the cell. Then next it is the blow up cock. Blow up cock is used to empty the boiler cell for a cleaning purpose. Then this part is known as the chimney. And the last part is the fusible plug. The fusible plug is installed on a main flue pipes. Okay, means on this tube the fusible plug is installed. Now in detail we understand the construction and working. Before moving ahead, I request to like the video and subscribe the channels by pressing the subscribe buttons. So first I show you some characteristic. The boiler is horizontal. Why it is horizontal? Its cell is horizontal, that's why it is known as the horizontal boiler. The Coltron boiler is vertical because its cell is vertical. Second, it is the stationary fire tube, means the fire is inside the tube, that's why it is known as the fire tube. Stationary because when it is stationary, it is not movable from one place to another place, that's why it is known as the stationary fire tube. Third point is internally fire, means the furnace is inside the boiler, that's why known as the internally fire. And multi-tube means more than one tube is used. Here we see that it is a two tubes. That's why it is known as the multi-tubes. And last point is the natural circulation of hot gas. Means the hot gas produced in this furnace is naturally circulated in boilers as well as in a brick construction. There is no any blowers is used. And Lenkes IR boiler is a medium pressure boiler. So these are the main characteristics. Next we move towards the specification, means what are the dimensions. The cell diameter is 2 to 3 meter, means this diameter is 2 to 3 meter. Length of the cell is 7 to 9 meter. Maximum working pressure is 16 bar. Steam capacity is 900 kg per hour, means 900 kg of steam is produced in a 1 hour and its efficiency is 50 to 70%. So next we move towards the important points of applications where it is used. So it is commonly used in sugar mills and textile industries where the power generation as well as the process heating is required. Now we learned a few points of the construction. It is helpful to return in examinations. So it consists of cylindrical cell and two fire tubes. So there is a one cylindrical cell, okay, that we already know, and a two fire tubes inside this cylindrical cell. Next point, the cylindrical cell is placed over the brick structure, means this cell is mounted on a brick construction. Third, the boiler have a three pass for a two flow of the flue gases, means we already studied that there is a three pass. One is the main flow, another is the bottom flow, and third one is the side flow. So these are the three different flow of a hot gases, and these three pass are formed by the brickwork. Okay, means there is a one main flow pass is inside the boiler and another two is depend on the brick construction. Okay, so it is outside of the cell, that is a bottom flow, in the bottom side of the cell, inside of the cell then it is known as a side flow. So this bottom and side is depend on the construction of the brickwork. The grate are provides at the front end and inside the two main fire tubes, means the furnace. Inside the furnace there a grate is used on which we are put the various fuel. So this is the grate and it is put inside this tube. The fire bridge is provided at the end of the grate, means here our grate is complete. So we putting the one fire bridge, and fire bridge is provided for a prevent the coil and ash particles entering into the interior of the furnace tube, means this part is avoid to supply the coal as well as the ash particles in a fire tubes. Okay, that's why the fire bridge is put at here. Superheater is provided at the end of main flue tubes. So here main flue tube is end. So this part here the superheater is installed. Okay, tubes in passage of flue gases. Also the economizer is used at the end of the side flue. So here the end flue is end on this part. Okay, so at that where it is also used the economizers before exhausting the gas to the chimney. And damper are also placed at the end of the side flue. So it is the end of the side flue. Okay, this is not the end. This is the end of the side flue. Okay, so because the bottom, the gases come first in main flue, then after bottom, and bottom to for this part it is coming in the side flue. And it is the starting of the side flue, then after it is moving here and it is the end. Then after it is going to the chimney to the atmosphere. Okay, so it is the starting of the side flue and it is the end, and at the end we put the this damper, and damper is used to control the mass flow rate of the gases. Okay, next is the working of a Lenkes air boiler, means how it is work. The coil is introduced to the grate through the fire hose. So here it is the grate and the coil is putting from this fire door. Next point is this combustion of the coal takes place in a presence of air, means combustion of any fuels we are required to the presence of air as well as the initial spark. So air is also provided and this is regulated by the damper. So this damper is not used for controlling the fresh air. There is another damper is provided, but it is not visible in this figure. The combustion will produce the hot gas, means here the combustion of the fuel is takes place, it's produced the hot gases, and these hot gases is passes in a different components. So that is known as the path of flue gases, means from where the flue gases is pass. So flue gas first come into this main flow. Okay, so hot gases from the grate pass up to back end of the tubes. This is a back end of the tubes, then in a downward directions, that is main flow to the bottom flow. Okay, so it is known as the MF to BF. Then they move by the bottom flue to the front of the boiler, means here the back part. Then bottom flow is come here, that is on the front part. So this is the front part. Okay, front of the boiler where they are divided in the two strings. So here this divide on the two string. One is come on this side and another is come on this side. Okay, dividing two string and pass into the side view. So it is third category is BF to SF. Then after they move along the two side flue and enters into the chimney. So here the side flue start and here it is an end. Through this damper it is supplied to this chimney and from the chimney it is discharged to the atmosphere. Due to this flue gas part, the water in the cell is heated from the bottom by the bottom flue, from the side by the side flue and from the center for a fire tube. Means this is the from this tube the hot gases is passes. Okay, so this tube is heat this water from a center part. When we pass it, pass the flue gases from the bottom, this heat this bottom waters, and when it is passed from a side flue, it's heat the water on a both the sides. Okay, so heating is takes place from a three side, from the center, from the bottom and from the two side. So damper are regulate the mass flow rate of the flue gases, combustion rate as well as the steam generation rate. So next is the advantages and disadvantages of Lenkes iron boilers. Due to three pass of a flue gas, the heating surface area per unit volume of boiler is large. Means there is a larger area for a heating. So better heating is takes place. The fluctuation in a load can easily meet by this boiler due to the large reservoir. Easy to operation, low maintenance cost, easy to clean and inspect. By use of economizer and superheater, maximum heat of a flue gases is utilized, so efficiency of boilers can be increased. So we know that economizer and superheater are one type of the accessories, and if you want to watch more video about the accessories and mounting, then I request to go into the playlist and watch all this video. And what is the disadvantages? The maximum working pressure is limited to 16 bar. So this Lenkes iron boiler is used up to the 16 bar pressure. Due to brickwork, more floor area is required. Means outside of the cell there is a brick construction. So due to brick construction, the area of requirement is increased. Response of pressure buildup is less. Means there is a more time is required to achieve the 16 bar pressure. The furnace is inside the tubes, therefore the grate area is restricted. So we know that the grate or furnace is provided inside the tubes. So there is a limited area for a combustion of the fuel. Okay. And this is a due to limited area, they are required a more response time to achieve and build up a certain pressure. So due to this limited area of the furnace, they are required more time to achieve a 16 bar pressure. So thank you for watching this video. If you learned, then like the video, subscribe to channels and share with your friends.